Yeah, I am ready here.
One second. Okay, very good evening to all of you. Namaste, good evening. Welcome to Yoga Scholars, PGIMER. So today we have with us Dr. Perumalji. Dr. Perumalji is working as the director of WCSC Vision Academy at Aliyar. It's in Eranthapuram, Jyoti Nagar. The institute offers various courses in the field of yoga, and the topic today is very interesting. It is the yoga for the human excellence. So now you will listen to Dr. K. Perumalji. Sir, I will switch off my voice. I will mute my voice. And now over to you. You can.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Respected professors, respected organizers, and dear scholars, students, brothers and sisters, I'm very much thankful to the organization for giving me an opportunity to share some of my ideas with these enthusiastic scholars. Generally, the yoga is our tradition, is our culture. So India is rich in yoga. Even though the science gets advanced in foreign countries, for all the yoga advancement, we can point only the India. So all Indians can be proud of the yoga. So with the help of the Prime Minister, the June 21st has been declared as the International Yoga Day, and it has been celebrated all over the world. So now let's see some of the importance of the yoga. The yoga for all people, generally we call it yoga for human excellence. Yeah, if we want to excel with all the human behavior, human attitude, we need yoga, the traditional yoga, which has been given by our Mahans, Jnanis, Siddhas, and the Rishis. Wonderful things it has been given. Particularly the Patanjali has designed everything. Similarly, the same thing has been designed here in Tirumular in southern area. Such a wonderful technique. Now let us see some of the important things about the yoga. Generally, the yoga is suitable for all the people, but particularly for the youth, it is very much suitable because youth, they are unselfish, they are more powerful, they are thrilling in nature, they are more energetic and skilled, and also strong. Even though the yoga is useful for all the people, we call this yoga for human excellence, and we emphasize more on the yoga for youth empowerment because they need more on the youth side. So now, you see, when you see here in India, the youth is more powerful. Even though some of the other countries, population may be high. China, the population may be high. But coming to India, the youth strength is more in India. Because in China, because of the family planning and all other restrictions, the youth strength has come down. But India, throughout the world, the youth strength is more here. So we can manage, we can do anything here. Such a human resource we have that. But generally what happens now, the youths are not properly motivated. They're not properly guided. And we can say they are a little bit undisciplined. Perplexes are there, confusions are there. They are not given the right path. And most of the youth, they are aimless. They are not recognized by society. Due regards should be given to the youth because they are going to rule the country in future. Then they are not provided the respect or the responsibility. So because of that, the youth, they tend to be violent. The frustrations, all kind of unwanted things are going on there with the youth side. So actually, they don't have a role model. So now you see, how many youths are suffering? The women, they are not given the proper respect. The children, the abandoned children, how many are there? So now this is time we have to think over it. Abdul Kalam told that India would be the greatest country within 2020. Now we are facing the 2020. But still we can take 5 years or 10 years. We have to make the India great. Yeah. So now here comes the yoga. So yoga is for a proper life. Yoga is not just mere asanas or some pranayams. It is for a way of life. It shows, it gives all the technique for a proper way of life. So using that yoga, we can overcome the tension and we can use it for achieving the mental peace, and for courage and confidence, then for bringing out the latent skills. Yeah, yoga can be used to bring out the latent skills. Generally, the education should be in the way to bring out the latent skills. Yoga for sharing the knowledge, yoga for learning the secrets of life. This is much important. This for learning the secrets of life. Yoga for realizing self and the nature. Yoga for happy and content life. Yoga is not mere asanas. Yoga is a way of life that helps us to bring all our talents for all the people, particularly for the youth. So here, our organization, we call us a World Community Service Center. It's aimed to achieve the world peace. So it has been founded by Swamiji Yogiraj Vedatri Magrissi in the year 1958. So here, what we do here is, the Swamiji Vedatri Magrissi has simplified all the asanas, pranayams into very simple exercises so that anybody can do that exercise. At the same time, it gives all the benefits of the asanas also. Very simple exercises gives the benefits of the asanas, pranayams, and the mudras. So everything has been synthesized within 45 minutes to 1 hour. Anybody can do it and enjoy the benefits of the asanas. Then comes the meditation. Yeah, a simple way of meditation, we call it here as the simplified Kundalini yoga. Anybody above the age of 14, they can do it. Then Kayakalpa practice. It's a wonderful practice that is available only here in the system. Kaya means the physical body. That is, kalpa means keeping the body fit and hale and healthy. A wonderful technique that has been taken from the Siddha tradition. It takes only 10 minutes in a day, but that makes you to improve your immunity level, postpones the aging process. You can maintain the youthfulness, particularly for the youth. It's a boon for the youth. The biological urge, sexual disturbance during that youth, that can be easily managed by doing this Kayakalpa practice. And also it's much helpful for all the people, particularly for the women, to get over all the menstrual problems. Such a wonderful technique. It's a Siddha technique. It takes only 10 minutes in a day. Then comes the introspection practices. To analyze where I am, what is my attitude, how I can improve. So that is called as introspection practice. Then sublimation, achieving the high quality, high attitude, perfection. Finally, realizing where I am, who am I? What is the relation between me and the nature, between me and the God, between me and the Almighty? So such a wonderful, the theories are given here. So these are all the very simple exercises. Anybody can do that. So there are some 9 parts of exercise. Exercise for the hands, exercise for the legs, exercise for the lungs, exercise for the eyes. Similarly, there are 9 types of exercise which stimulates the entire body. Then comes the meditation. It's a very good technique. Already it has been taken from our Siddhas. Yeah. The practice helps strengthen the life force. Yeah, the Kayakalpa, it's a wonderful technique. It takes only 10 minutes in a day. Yeah. When you do the meditation, what happens? The mental frequency that comes down. If you measure your mental frequency using a EEG electroencephalograph, when you're angry, when you're in tension, when you're in frustration, actually that waves will be going high. That we call as beta wave. You cannot take any positive decision. Whatever you do, that will be leading to failure. At the same time, if you meditate, if you pray, if you chant mantras, and if you're happy, then your mind will come to the alpha wave, that is 8 to 13. That frequency will be 8 to 13. There only you can do some positive things. There only you can read. There only you can write. There only you can study. There only you can concentrate. Then if you do meditation, go subtler level, there's the 4 to 7 frequencies. There only all the scientists, they're working there in the frequency. Everything coming there will be a novel, creative ideas. Then if you do meditation, go deeply, then finally you'll be coming to the stage of 1 to 3. The mental frequency will be there. That is called Samadhi, becoming equivalent to the Almighty. Almost all the Mahans, they will be at that stage through the penance and the hard efforts and the deep meditation, finally they will reach there. So there comes the mind merging with the Almighty, and it knows all the secrets of the universe. Remaining at one place, they can analyze the entire universe. The entire universe will be under their control. So their mind can expand throughout the universe. All the secrets of the universe can be brought in there. Such a wonderful frequency anybody can achieve. The only thing is they go to meditate. It doesn't come out immediately. It takes years of heart efforts. So these are all the points in the body. The 7 chakras in the body, they go to activate the chakras through the meditation. The Mooladhara, that is called the center of the body. Exactly the center of the body, around which only the reproductive systems will be there. Then Swadhisthana, so that is just 4 inches below the navel point. Then Manipuraha, that is at the navel point. Anahata, that is between the lungs. Dushiti, that is in the neck region. Agna, that is between the eyebrows. Then Duryam, so that is at the top of the head. So these are all the 7 points, or 7 chakras, 7 magnetic domains in which you can meditate. You can achieve the different benefits there. When you do the meditation at Agna and Durya, your mind gets focused and your intelligence goes high. And Durya, so that stimulates all the cells of the brain and your attention capacity, memory, it goes high and it gives a link to the divinity. Such wonderful things are available in the body. The only thing is we have to take effort and meditate over the particular points. So these are all connected to the different organs, particularly the endocrine systems of the body. See, the Agna and Durya, they are much related to the pituitary and the pineal glands. The Dushiti, the meditative at the neck, so it is related to the thyroid and the parathyroid glands. Then the chest region, where comes the Anahata, so it is related to the thymus gland. Then coming down, that Manipuraha, that's related to the pancreas. Then the other, when you go below, the Swadhisthana, that is related to the adrenals. So almost all these magnetic chakras are related to the endocrine glands in the body. When you meditate at a particular point, then the particular gland that works in a harmonious way. So first, that physical fitness, a healthy attitude, and a physical strength we can achieve, and physical, the streamlining of the body inside. So when you meditate on all these centers, what happens? Even the circulations inside the body, the blood circulation, heat circulation, air circulation, and the life force circulation inside the body, they all will streamline. There will be harmonious circulations in the body. And all these organs, they will be tuned to that level. So these are all the different types of meditation. Generally, we go to the meditation at the Agna Durya level. Then further, even we can go beyond the body level, that we call as Durya Theta meditation. All right, then comes the introspection practice by which we can analyze and we can find the positive qualities and the negative qualities, and we can improve our positive qualities, and we can take away or thrown out all our negative qualities. Then sublimation, that's making the habit permanent one. We can first analyze, then we can make our habit a permanent one. Then perfection, finally analyzing and becoming one with the nature. How that the Ramana Maharshi, the Vallalar, Vedatri Maharshi, Vivekananda, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, how they achieved that samadhi stage, how they achieved that realization. Similarly, anybody can achieve by a sincere practice. So these are all the benefits coming there. You see how Vivekananda says about the education. Education is the manifestation of perfection already in man. Yeah, there is a perfection within everybody that has to be achieved. Education should help the way. It stimulates the students to bring out all the talents. So what has not been done by the school education or the college education, it can be done by the spiritual education, because our masters, they have given wonderful techniques. So by which anybody can, their all the talents can be manifested out. Now, generally, the practice here that helps the body, life energy, and the mind, all the three, that we can rejuvenate the energy and we can harmonize. And what happens by after practicing this, the thought, word, and deed, they all will become beneficial. And that improves relationship with the family, friends, elders, and teachers. And also improves attention, strengthens the mind, and improves self-confidence. These are all the benefits of yoga. There are different types of yoga available. Whatever may be the system, we admire all the systems, because all the systems, they will be formed by the wise persons, the Mahans, the Siddhas, the philosophers. It has been formed by them. So we respect all the systems. So whichever is possible, we can adopt them. And when you do this practice sincerely, then we will get the limitations in watching TV, internet, movies, unwanted things will get automatically limited. At the same time, and for the youth, the untoward such desire, they would come down. the excess sexual passion that can be eradicated. Association in terms of religion, caste, language, and gender. So when you see that, the yoga is common for all the people, irrespective of the age, caste, gender, it is common for all the people. It gives an improvement for all the people and improves the personality of all the people. And you can plan your future suitably. And yeah, besides everything, it makes the family a pleasant one. Particularly the practice of Kayakalpa, that stimulates all the endocrine glands and helps the students' community. It's a boon for the students' community that helps improve, regulate mental functions, concentration, and memory power. It takes only 10 minutes in a day, but it gives a lot of benefits to all the people. Yeah. And then these are all the different exercises here, which is defined by the Swamiji. And yeah, just we are all over there. So these are all the different exercise postures. And it's very simple. Anybody can do that exercise. At the same time, they can enjoy the benefits. So this is the breathing exercise in which the lungs is expanded and contracted in different modes. So the finally comes the relaxation. So there are 9 exercises given here. It takes only 45 minutes a day. Anybody who does, and their physical health will improve a lot. Then the meditation. Sitting in any asana, you can meditate. So this is the only way to control the mind. And then here comes the Nadi Shuddhi. And this is using that Nasika Mudra. Then they can do that Nadi Shuddhi, which is called, it comes as a one type of pranayama, slowly inhaling and slowly exhaling. Inhaling through one nose and exhaling through the another nose. So which we call as a Nadi Shuddhi. These are the techniques we can do that. Okay, all right. And actually to take this education to the mass level, now even now we have started a online education. Actually, we have tied up with the different universities in Tamil Nadu, almost all the universities in Tamil Nadu, some of the universities in other states, 30 universities. So through the universities, through the distance education mode, we are giving certificate, diploma, BSc, MSc, in Yoga for Human Excellence. Besides that, we organize a research center, which has been approved by the Bharatiya University of Tamil Nadu, through which 60 MPhil students and 75 PhD students are pursuing their research in different aspects of yoga. We verify each and every aspect of yoga. When the particular yoga is done for the youth, and what will be the result? If it is done by the women, what will be the result? If it is done by the elders, what will be the result? So similarly, we analyze each and everything. We have some more than 200 journal papers published in different journals, with referred journals, and the things are going here nicely. So here, there's a practical center here, a training center in Pollachi, which is called near Aliyar. We call the places Arad Parinchodi Nagar. So this has been founded by Swamiji Vedatri Maharishi. And this system we call as the simplified Kundalini Yoga. You see, so Kunda means it's some heat energy inside the body. To maintain the heat energy, the life force should be there inside the body. So that life force is responsible for the maintaining the heat energy, that we generally we call as the Kundalini. So taking that energy to the different chakras and meditating over there, that gives a lot of benefits. So these are all the simple aspects given here through our system. That is mainly the physical exercise for the physical body and the Kayakalpa exercise for rejuvenating the energy throughout the body. Then the meditation, that is for the focusing and concentrating the mind and bringing your that intelligence and merging the consciousness with the nature or the Almighty. And merging our mind with Almighty, or almost we can make the mind still. Generally, the mind is wavering, wandering. We can make the mind be a static state. That's called as the Samadhi level. So these are all the different aspects covered here in our system, which we call as the World Community Service Center and Simplified Kundalini Yoga. I'm very much thankful for the organizers for giving me an opportunity to share some of these. And also I welcome almost all the listeners here, participants here. When there's a chance for you, please come over here to our center. Our center, this is the biggest center here. And we have some 400 centers throughout the world. In Tamil Nadu itself, we have some 300 centers and another 100 centers in the other states and the other countries we are having that. And for to teach this mechanism to the people, we have 16,000 trained masters. We call us the professors in our system. And we have a cadre of assistant professors, professors and senior professors in the system. They will teach the system to anybody else. Besides that, we have adopted some 200 villages. For the villages, we are giving the system freely to all the people. We adopt the villages of 500 to 1,000 population. We give the yoga freely to all the people, and we make that village a peaceful village. We adopt the village for 1 year. After 1 year training, the yoga training given to the village, we find a lot of changes are coming there in the villages. Because you know that India, in which the villages are more, and the village people, they play a major role in the development of the country. So we take this yoga to the villages also. So with that, let me conclude. I have taken a little more time. With that, let me conclude. I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity. Now, if there are any queries, we can discuss. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. May the whole world enjoy prosperity, wisdom, and peace. May the whole world enjoy prosperity, wisdom, and peace. Thank you very much. Be blessed. Be blessed.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for enlightening us. It was very nice talk. We learned so much. I have a question. I understand the physical benefits of pranayama, but can you explain how the practices of pranayama can help us achieve the human excellence, and can it improve our social relations also?
Yeah, thank you. You see, the pranayama, there are different types of pranayama available. Actually, we should be proud of our elders. They have given the very good techniques to us. So once you do the pranayama, there is slowly inhaling and slowly exhaling. So what happens? More oxygen you get there. That oxygen is distributed throughout the body. The brain receives more oxygen. And the brain receives more oxygen, its memory capacity that increases. When the oxygen goes to each and every cell of the system, the prana, that is the energy. So that energy has been given through the oxygen now. So the entire body is activated. Entire body is strengthened. The brain receives more oxygen. The brain receives more oxygen. It needs oxygen. You see, without food, we can survive for 10 days or 15 days. Without water, we can survive for some 4 or 5 days. Without oxygen, we cannot survive for even 3 minutes. Because such a need we have that over the oxygen. So therefore, the pranayama is a way in which we increase the oxygen content that has been taken through, absorbed by the blood, and it is distributed throughout the body. Therefore, all the cells are rejuvenated. That's why particularly what they say is, if you do the pranayama in the morning, the 4:30 to 6, you can do the pranayama at any time, but the morning time, if you do that, you get more oxygen. The morning, which is called Brahma Muhurtam, the 4:36 o'clock time, so there the atmosphere will fill with more oxygen. Therefore, once the oxygen goes here and rejuvenates the body, your memory capacity, that improves. Your attitude, that improves. So our elders, they have given a wonderful technique. Just you spare some time for that. Particularly in the morning, between 4:30 to 6, you do the pranayama. Inhale slowly, slowly. More oxygen goes there. Sometime you return, keep it there. Then exhale slowly. The exhaling time should be almost double the time of the inhaling time. So if you do that slowly, immediately you can feel that the rejuvenating the body, the energy comes to the body. Because the oxygen is available in the universe, in the air, just we take it. It's not just need to buy oxygen here. So such a wonderful technique our elders have given. We have to pray them. We have to express our gratitude to those elders found such wonderful pranayams. They have given hundreds of pranayams. At least whatever possible we can do it. So here we have given one simple technique, Nadi Shuddhi. So there are different techniques. At least let us do one or two daily. We can enjoy the benefits. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for wonderful talks. I am sure that everyone has got benefited. All the viewers must have got some new insights about the topic. Thank you for being with us and enlightening us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.